ഹലോ മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, വെൽക്കം ടു ഓൾ. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് അവർ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ടൈം. ലെറ്റ് എസ് ബിഗിൻ. വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ഡേയ്സ് അസൈൻമെൻറ്സ്? ഐ തിങ്ക് ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ഹാവ് ഡൺ ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ എ ബെറ്റർ വേ. വാട്ട് വാസ് ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് ടാസ്ക്? യെസ്, ടു ഡ്രോ മീഡിയ ട്രീ. ഡിഡ് യു ഐഡൻറ്റിഫൈ ദ സിംബൽസ് ആൻഡ് ഐക്കൺസ്? വെരി ഗുഡ്. ലെറ്റ് എസ് സീ സം സാമ്പിൾസ്. Have you seen the samples? I think you also have done it in the same way. Okay, what was the next task? Yes, to frame questions to know how messages were sent in the past. Did you write the questions? Okay, very nice. Let us listen to some of our friends.
Which were the technique used to convey messages in the past? Was there any post office or ranchal office in your locality in the past? Tell me more about it. How long did it take to send and receive letters in Kerala? Who brought you letters in the past? Which were the workers used to carry letters in that period? Did any other system exist during that period to send and receive messages? Which system was more easy and comfortable to convey messages in that period? Did you ever send or receive telegram? Tell me more about it.
Which were the vehicles used to carry messages in the past? How did you inform about the family functions to your relatives who were in faraway places? Did any vehicles drawn by animals used to carry messages in the past in our locality? When did post come into being? How did you send letters? Were there any post offices nearby who delivered letters in the past?
What was the last task? Yes, to read the passages, the story of messages and the radio. I think all of you read them very well. In the last class, we talked about the Pony Express. It was formed in the year 1860. Now, have a look at the statue of Pony Express at St. Joseph, Missouri. Okay friends, now I shall read the rest of the passage. You should read along with me. The speed was a bonus because it cut the average delivery time from several weeks to about 10 days. The fastest trip was made in 7 days and 17 hours. This record was set by the rider carrying President Abraham Lincoln's first message to the US Congress. The poor riders had to ride through unknown terrains. Some routes exposed them to attacks from Red Indians and led them through dangerous territories. Newspaper advertisement for riders listed one important requirement: offense preferred. Though exciting, the Pony Express was a short-lived experiment. It lasted for only 19 months. By then, there was a telegraph line from coast to coast. This was definitely a faster way of sending messages. But the invention of the radio brought in a great revolutionary change in the field of communication. The speed was a bonus. How? In what sense was speed a bonus? Can you tell me? Yes, it cut the average delivery time from several weeks to about 10 days. That means before the Pony Express, it took several weeks to deliver letters. But with the arrival of Pony Express, it was reduced to about 10 days. So, speed was a bonus. Which was the fastest trip? Can you tell me? Yes, the record was set by the rider carrying President Abraham Lincoln's first message to the US Congress. എബ്രഹാം ലിങ്കൻ ആരാണെന്ന് കൂട്ടുകാർക്ക് അറിയാമോ? അതെ, ശരിയാണ്. അമേരിക്കൻ ഐക്യനാടുകളിലെ 16-ാമത്തെ പ്രസിഡന്റ് ആയിരുന്നു എബ്രഹാം ലിങ്കൻ. അടിമത്തത്തിനെതിരെ നിരന്തരം പോരാടിയ അദ്ദേഹം അടിമത്തം പൂർണ്ണമായി നിരോധിച്ചുകൊണ്ടുള്ള ഉത്തരവിറക്കുകയും ചെയ്തു. എബ്രഹാം ലിങ്കന്റെ ആദ്യ സന്ദേശം US കോൺഗ്രസിലേക്ക് വഹിച്ചുകൊണ്ടുപോയ കുതിരക്കാരനാണ് ഏറ്റവും വേഗതയേറിയ കുതിരക്കാരനായി കണക്കാക്കപ്പെടുന്നത്. ആരാണ് ഈ കുതിരക്കാരൻ എന്നറിയണ്ടേ? അതെ, റോബർട്ട് ഹസ്ലമായിരുന്നു ഈ കുതിരക്കാരൻ. ഹി ടുക്ക് 7 days and 17 hours. വാട്ട് ഡു യു മീൻ ബൈ US കോൺഗ്രസ്? യെസ്, ദ ലോ മേക്കിംഗ് ബോഡി ഇൻ US. അതെ, അമേരിക്കയിലെ നിയമനിർമ്മാണ സഭയാണ് US കോൺഗ്രസ്. വാട്ട് വെയർ ദ ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ടീസ് എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ്ഡ് ബൈ ദ പോണി എക്സ്പ്രസ് റൈഡേഴ്സ്? ക്യാൻ യു ടെൽ മീ? ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഫ്രം യുവർ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക്. യെസ്, ദ പൂവർ റൈഡേഴ്സ് ഹാഡ് ടു റൈഡ് ത്രൂ അൺനോൺ ടെറൈൻസ്. വാട്ട് ഡു യു മീൻ ബൈ ടെറൈൻസ്? യെസ്, ഏരിയാസ് ഓഫ് ലാൻഡ്. ദ പൂവർ റൈഡേഴ്സ് how to ride through unknown areas of land. Adhe ariyappadatha bhoopradeshangalilude yathra cheyyendi varumayirunnu ee kudirakarku. Sometimes they faced the attacks from Red Indians. Yes, these Native American tribes sometimes attacked the Pony Express riders. So it led them through dangerous territories. Newspaper advertisement for Pony Express riders listed one important requirement. What was that? I ask you to find out the answer of this question in the last day. Did you find out the answer? Okay, let us listen to some of our friends.
Orphans preferred that was the important requirement for Pony Express riders.
Newspaper advertisement for riders listed one important requirement orphans preferred.
Are they right? Yes. അനാഥരായിരുന്നു പോണി എക്സ്പ്രസ് റൈഡേഴ്സായി തിരഞ്ഞെടുത്തിരുന്നത്. ഈ ആവശ്യത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് കൂട്ടുകാരുടെ അഭിപ്രായം എന്താ? Yes, it was against justice. എല്ലാ ജീവനും വിലപ്പെട്ടതാണ് അല്ലേ? Though exciting, Pony Express was a short-lived experiment. Why? What was the reason behind this? Can you tell me? Yes, there came telegraph line from coast to coast. It was speeder than Pony Express. So, Pony Express was a short-lived experiment. It lasted only for 19 months. Then radio was invented. The invention of radio brought a revolutionary change in the field of communication. Friends, now a friend of you will read the passage. Listen to it carefully.
The speed was a bonus because it cut the average delivery time from several weeks to about 10 days. The fastest trip was made in 7 days and 17 hours. This record was set by the rider carrying President Abraham Lincoln's first message to the US Congress. The poor riders had to ride through unknown terrains. Some routes exposed them to attack from Red Indians and
led them through dangerous territories. Newspaper advertisements for riders listed one important requirement orphans prefer. Though exciting, the Pony Express was a short-lived experiment. It lasted for only 19 months. By then, there was a telegraph line from coast to coast. This was definitely a faster way of sending messages. But the invention of the radio brought in a great revolutionary change in the field of communication.
Friends, now have a look at this. What do you see here? Yes, the Pony Express is written at the center. Can you tell me a word related to the Pony Express? Tell me. Yes, freight company. Can you tell me another word related to Pony Express? Yes, rugged route. Like this way, you have to find out words related to Pony Express and complete the word verb. This is the first task for today. Now, have a look at this sentence. Read this sentence. The Pony Express riders were chosen for their lightweight as well as their riding ability. It is a lengthy sentence, isn't it? Yes, let us split this sentence into two. How can we split this sentence? Tell me. Yes, the Pony Express riders were chosen for their lightweight. Then, yes, they were also chosen for their riding ability. Friends, when we combine these two sentences, we will avoid they were also chosen for and add as well as in that place. Now, have a look at the words given on page number 103 of your textbook. Read the words. Yes, you can do some of them and your friends can do some of them. Suppose you can drive a car and you can also ride a bike. Then how can we write the sentence? Yes, I can drive a car as well as ride a bike. Suppose your friend Baby can draw pictures. He can also paint portraits. Then how can we write the sentence? Yes, my friend Baby can draw pictures as well as paint portraits. Like this way, you have to frame more sentences using as well as, selecting words from here. Okay? This is the next task for today. It is given on page number 103 of your textbook. Now have a look at these sentences. The teachers as well as the headmaster are the members of the club. Here are functions as the verb. The verb are agrees with the first subject, the teachers. The teachers as well as the headmaster are the members of the club. Now look at the next sentence. The moon as well as the stars gives us light. Which is the verb here? Yes, gives. The verb gives agrees with the first subject, the moon. The moon as well as the stars gives us light. In these type of sentences, the verb always agrees with the first subject. You should keep this in your mind and frame sentences using as well as. Okay, this is the next task for you. It is also given on page number 103 of your textbook. Friends, listen, someone wants to tell us something. Come on, let us listen to it.
Hello friends, do you know me? I'm Radio. I'm just over 100 years old. It was Marconi who invented me. I was in fact developed from telegraph. You know, I have many advantages. I am much more portable medium than television. I allow you to carry on listening you at your work. If you use me, your imagination capacity will be developed. You know, I am the theater of the mind. Friends, you can close your eyes, but you can't close your ears. But nowadays, people have no interest on me. That's why I'm so sad. Friends, you know, I'm waiting for with different programs. Entertainment programs, music programs, morning wake-up shows, news and weather segments, radio dramas, live shows, sport programs, educational programs. So, don't forget to use me wisely.
Who is that? Yes, the radio. Do you have a habit of listening to the radio? Very good. Which programs do you listen to? Music? Radio dramas? Sports news? Oh, you listen to a lot of programs. Very good. ലോക റേഡിയോ ദിനം എന്നാണ് ആചരിക്കുന്നതെന്ന് കൂട്ടുകാർക്കറിയാമോ? അതെ, February 13 ലോക റേഡിയോ ദിനമായി ആചരിക്കുന്നത്. യുനെസ്കോ, ബ്രോഡ്കാസ്റ്റേഴ്സ് ഓർഗനൈസേഷൻസ്, വിവിധ കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റീസ് എന്നിവയുമായി ചേർന്ന് ലോകവ്യാപകമായി ലോക റേഡിയോ ദിനം ആചരിക്കുന്നു. ഡു യു വാണ്ട് ടു നോ മോർ അബൌട്ട് റേഡിയോ? ഓക്കെ, ഐ ഷാൽ റീഡ് ദ പാസേജ് The radio given in our textbook. You should read along with me. The radio. The radio is just over 100 years old. It was Marconi who invented an instrument to send the wireless message. He sent the first radio message in 1895. This marked the birth of the radio. It was in fact developed from the telegraph, which was invented by Cook and Wheaton in 1835. Later, it was perfected by Morse. The word telegraph is derived from the two Greek words telos, which means distant, and grapho, which means to write. The invention of the telephone by Alexander Graham Bell in the year 1876 was another revolutionary step in the field of communication. It became more popular because the person at the other end could hear the speaker's voice. Who invented radio? Yes, Marconi invented radio. In which year? Can you tell me? Yes, in 1895. He sent the first wireless message in 1895. You know, radio was developed from telegraph. Who invented telegraph? Can you tell me? Yes, Cook and Wheaton invented telegraph. In which year? Yes, in 1835.
Samuel Morse perfected the telegraph.
Telegraph is derived from two Greek words. Which are they? Can you tell me? Yes, correct. Telos and grapho. What are their meanings? Tell me. Yeah, telos means distant. Grapho means to write. Who invented telephone? Can you tell me? Yes, Alexander Graham Bell invented telephone. In which year? Yes, in 1876. It became more popular. Why? What was the reason behind this? Yes, the person from the other end could hear the speaker's voice. So, it became very popular. Yes, the invention of telephone was also another revolutionary change in the field of communication. Friends, Now, a friend of you will read the passage. Listen carefully.
The radio. The radio is just over 100 years old. It was Marconi who invented an instrument to send the wireless message. He sent the first radio message in 1895. This marked the birth of the radio. It was in fact developed from the telegraph, which was invented by Cook and Wheatstone in 1835. Later, it was perfected by Morse. The word telegraph is derived from the two Greek words telos, which means distant, and grapho, which means to write. The invention of the telephone by Alexander Graham Bell in the year 1876 was another revolutionary step in the field of communication. It became more popular because the person at the other end could hear the speaker's voice.
Friends, something is going on there. Come on, let us watch it.
Papa, let me see the cartoon, please. I want to see it.
I have my favorite cereal now. Let me see it. Oh, I want to know what will happen to Tulsi. Give me the remote. Give it.
It is time for Ramayana. I want to see that. Oh, my dear son, please tune that channel for me. Narayana, Narayana.
Oh, no. I must see the cricket match. I want to know which team will win today. Papa, please let me watch.
Oh, will you please stop this? You don't allow me to watch the news. Oh my God, what a fate.
What do you see here? Yes, a quarreling for watching television programs. Does this happen in your house? Sometimes. Okay. What does the grandmother like to watch? Can you tell me? Yes, the grandmother likes to watch Ramayana. What about the girl? Yes, the girl likes to watch cartoon. And what is the boy's preference? Yes, correct. He wants to watch cricket match. And what about the mother? Yes, she wants to see serial. And what does the father like to watch? Yes, father likes to watch news. We know that different people have different taste in watching television programs. Television nammude jeevithathe albhudagaramaya vidham swadheenichirikkunnu. It educates us, it entertains us, and it broadens our knowledge horizons. Adhe ഭാഷാപരവും ഭൂമിശാസ്ത്രപരവും സാംസ്കാരികവുമായ അതിർവരമ്പുകൾ കടന്ന് ലോകത്തെ മനുഷ്യരുടെയും സംഭവങ്ങളുടെയും സജീവ ചിത്രങ്ങൾ നമുക്ക് മുന്നിൽ എത്തിച്ചു തരുന്നു ടെലിവിഷൻ. യെസ്, ഇറ്റ് ബ്രിങ്സ് ദ വേൾഡ് ഇൻ ഫ്രണ്ട് ഓഫ് അസ്. ടെലിവിഷൻ ഹാസ് ബിക്കം എ സിംബൽ ഓഫ് കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേഷൻ ഇൻ ടുഡേയ്സ് വേൾഡ്. That's why the General Assembly of United Nations declared November 21 as the World Television Day. Friends, do you want to know more about the television? Okay, I shall read the passage from your textbook. You should read along with me. The television. The television is one of the miracles of science. It is not an idiot box, but a magic carpet. Do you know who invented the television? It was a Scotsman named J.L. Baird. Baird made it possible to present moving and living pictures of men and events on the screen. In those days, it was only in monochrome, black and white. The color television became popular in the 1970s. Its vast potentialities as a powerful medium of mass communication cannot be underestimated. It is indeed one of the best sources of entertainment and enlightenment for all. Programs on subjects like health and hygiene, nutrition, family planning and agriculture are of immense help to men and women, especially in rural areas. Why do we say that television is a magic carpet? Can you tell me? Yes, it is one of the miracles of science. It brings the world in front of us. It presents the living and moving pictures of men and events on the screen. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെയാണ് ടെലിവിഷൻ ഒരു മാന്ത്രിക പരവതാനിയായി കണക്കാക്കപ്പെടുന്നത്. Who invented television? Can you tell me? Yes, J.L.
Byard.
John Logie
Byard
invented television. At that time, it was in monochrome. What do you mean by monochrome? Can you tell me? Yes, black and white. Have a look at these black and white televisions. Color televisions became popular in 1970s. A word is used with the meaning abilities. Can you tell me the word? Yes, potentialities. Potentialities means abilities. Television has its vast potentialities as a powerful medium of mass communication. ഒരു ബഹുജന മാധ്യമം എന്ന നിലയിൽ ടെലിവിഷന്റെ അനന്ത സാധ്യതകൾ നമുക്കൊരിക്കലും വില കുറച്ച് കാണാൻ കഴിയില്ല. Can you tell me how television is helpful to the people in rural areas? Tell me. Yes, the programs on subject like health and hygiene, nutrition, family planning and agriculture are of immense help to the men and women in rural areas. Aarogyam, aarogya paripalanam, krishi, kudumbasoothranam, പോഷകാഹാരം എന്നീ വിവിധ വിഷയങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ചുള്ള നിരവധി പരിപാടികൾ ടെലിവിഷനിലൂടെ സംപ്രേഷണം ചെയ്യപ്പെടുന്നുണ്ട്. ഇത് നാട്ടിൻപുറങ്ങളിലെ സ്ത്രീകൾക്കും പുരുഷന്മാർക്കും ഒരുപോലെ പ്രയോജനപ്രദമാണ്. യെസ്, ദ ടെലിവിഷൻ ഈസ് ഇൻഡീഡ് വൺ ഓഫ് ദ ബെസ്റ്റ് സോഴ്സസ് ഓഫ് എൻ്റർടൈൻമെൻറ്റ് ആൻഡ് എൻലൈറ്റൻമെൻറ്റ് ഫോർ ഓൾ. മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, നൗ വൺ ഓഫ് യുവർ ഫ്രണ്ട്സ് വിൽ റീഡ് ദിസ് പാസേജ്. Listen to it carefully.
The television is one of the miracles of science. It is not an idiot box but a magic carpet. Do you know who invented the television? It was a Scotsman named J.L. Byard. Byard made it possible to present moving and living pictures of men and events on the screen. In those days, it was only in monochrome, black and white. The color television became popular in the 1970s. Its vast potentialities as a powerful medium of mass communication cannot be underestimated. It is indeed one of the best sources of entertainment and enlightenment for all. Programs on subjects like health and hygiene, nutrition, family planning and agriculture are of immense help to men and women, especially in rural areas.
Have you read the passage along with her? Okay. Very good. Today you have some tasks to do. What are those tasks? Do you remember? I shall tell you once again. Listen carefully. Number 1, complete the word verb the pony express. Number 2, make maximum sentences using as well as by selecting words given on page number 103 of your textbook. Write more sentences using as well as by examining the given sentences on page number 103. Read the passage, the television. Find out difficult words and write their meanings. My dear children, we stop today's activities here. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye-bye.